Hi students, today I am going to teach you graphical representation of motion. So in this graphical representation motion, there are so many graphs like distance versus time graph, velocity time graph, and how to find the speed from the distance time graph, how to find the acceleration from velocity time graph, how to find the distance from velocity time graph. So for this, first of all, I explain you about slope. So what is the meaning of slope? So slope is equal to change in vertical divided by change in horizontal. Then what is the meaning of change in vertical? Suppose we take a graph. In any graph, there are two axes. One is a vertical axis, that means y axis, and the second one is a horizontal axis, that is called as the x axis. So how to find the slope from this graph? So first of all, you have to find the vertical change, that means this change. This is the linear graph, and to find the slope, first of all, take any two points on this graph. So I have to take a two points, one is A and second one is B. And to find the slope, first of all, take the vertical change, that means here BC is a vertical change and AC is a horizontal change. So slope is equal to BC divided by AC. So what is the value of BC and AC? You can find this graph easily. Then here value of BC is 10 and value of AC is 14. So value of the slope is 10 divided by 14. In this way, you can find the slope from any graph. Understood? So now, distance time graph. So in distance time graph, distance is in x direction and time is in y direction. So from this, slope is equal to distance divided by time, because of in vertical direction distance and in horizontal direction there is a time. But distance divided by time is the formula for the speed, that means slope is equal to speed. That means if you want to find the speed from the distance versus time graph, then you have to find this slope. Same thing in velocity time graph. Velocity in y direction and time is in x direction. Then what is the value of slope? So slope is equal to velocity, that means vertical, divided by time, that means horizontal. But velocity time is the formula for the acceleration. So if you want to find the acceleration from the velocity time graph, then you have to find the slope from this graph. Then another example here, in this graph there is a horizontal line, and this horizontal line have any no slope, that means value of slope is zero. You can easily say that because of line is horizontal, then value of slope is zero. And if value of slope is zero in velocity time graph, that means acceleration is zero. And if acceleration is zero, then you can say that velocity is constant. Understood? Then in this way, you can easily find the speed, acceleration from any graph of distance time graph or velocity time graph. Okay. Now, can we find the distance from VT graph, that means velocity time graph? Yes, you can find the acceleration from VT graph, but can we find the distance from velocity time graph? Then yes, distance, to find the distance, you have to find the area under the graph. Clear? If you want to find the distance from the velocity time graph, you have to find the area under the graph. Then how to find the area? Let's take the example. Suppose this is the one graph, velocity time graph, and from this graph I want to find the distance from 10 second to 20 second, from 10 second to 20 seconds. So how to find the distance? So from 10 second to 20 seconds, you have to find this whole area under the curve. That means area of this triangle ADE and area of this rectangle ADCA. Clear? So total area is area of the triangle and area of this rectangle, and this total area gives the value of distance of this velocity time graph for 10 to 20 seconds. If you find the 0 to 25 seconds, then you can draw the whole triangle, and from this triangle you can find the total area, and this area gives a distance from 0 to 25 seconds. Clear? So whatever time you given, then you can easily find the distance from the velocity time graph. Clear? So acceleration is equal to slope, velocity from velocity time graph. If you want to find the acceleration, then you have to slope, and again if you want to find the distance, then you have to find the area under the graph. Then some conclusion. So what are the conclusions? And you have to remember this conclusion. This conclusion is not given. This is one type of rules. It's my own rule, not given in any textbook. So you have to remember for knowledge, and you can apply for any type of graph, not only distance type graph, not only velocity time graph. You can apply these rules for any type of graph. So first rule is, if division are there, then you have to find the slope. If a multiplication, then you have to find the area. So how can you apply these rules? So take one example for distance time graph. Suppose for distance time graph, if you want to find the speed, so what is the formula of speed? Speed is equal to distance divided by time. You know very well, speed is equal to distance divided by time. So that means here distance is in y-axis and time is in x-axis. Then speed is equal to distance divided by time. That means division of distance and time. Division of distance and time. And if division, then what we have to do? They find the slope. Understood? Then if you given velocity time graph, then if you want to find the acceleration, so what is the formula of acceleration? Velocity of time, velocity divided by time. So here velocity and time both are in ratio, that means division, and for division you have to find the slope. That means from velocity time graph you want to find the acceleration, then you have to find the slope. Now if you want to find the distance from the velocity time graph, then what is the formula of distance in terms of velocity and time? So distance is equal to velocity into time. That means multiplication are there of velocity and time. Then multiplication, that means you have to find the area. So these are the common rules, and you can easily understand the when you have to find the slope and area under the curve. Clear? These all the rules for graphical representation of motion is used in any graph. Clear? And it is useful for the kinematic equations for the uniformly accelerated motion. Clear? Thank you.